Hello children, welcome back to the unit of inquiry class. So successfully we have completed the inquiry process of the first theme, that is who we are, and I really appreciate each and every one of you for making the self-identity box as a part of your learning, because each one of you have done it in a great way by including your beliefs, values, traditions and cultures. That was great. So going on to the second theme, we started off with guessing the theme where I showed you a few pictures. And many of you shared your perspectives on that, like a few of you said it is the electric post, and you said that something is pricking the earth because of the pictures, and someone is thinking there, someone is reading, and here you can see people are traveling from one place to another, and you had different perspectives while you were guessing the theme. So when these two pictures were shown, you had a doubt whether it is how the world works or where we are in place and time, because that includes the continents, everything. So by looking at the first picture, you had a perspective that it was how the world works, but when you saw the second picture, you had an idea that it would be where we are in place and time. Then I showed you this part, and this part helped you a lot to guess the theme very correctly, because it had got certain words related to the theme like gravity, sink or float, simple machines that you have already learnt in grade 2, then pushes and pulls that also you have learnt about, magnets, heat, and you could see the experiments and the description of the theme. Okay, and we also discussed about the technology, how technology is used in day-to-day life, that to now during the pandemic. So all these pictures helped you to guess the theme, and yes, you were right in guessing the theme. So before we guess, before we reveal it, I would like to read out the description for you of the theme. An inquiry into the natural world and its laws. The interaction between the natural world, physical and biological, and human societies, how humans use their understanding of scientific principles, the impact of scientific and technological advances on society and on the environment. So by looking at the technology, the picture that you know, spoke about the technology and the experiments, you were able to connect with the words here, like scientific and technological advances and scientific principles, where you connected it with the last year's inquiry process about simple machines. So that really helped you a lot to guess the theme, and yes, you were right, it was nothing but how the world works. So guessing the theme was really done in a great way by you people, because I was really wondering, I was, you know, mesmerized by looking at your perspectives, different perspectives in different ways. So you really, you all are thinking. And to make you guess the, you know, central idea. So instead of making you guess the central idea, what I thought was, let us bring up the word, at least one word from the central idea. To make that an easy process, I gave you an activity where you had to do the, you know, like you had to look around you and, you know, name the objects and what it is made up of. So these were the examples that I gave you, and here also you did a tremendous job, because you came up with different objects and different materials. So this helped you to guess the topic, like materials, immediately when I asked you what I'm made up of. So many of you asked me like a question, are we going to learn about materials? So I couldn't reveal at that time, because I wanted you to guess it right. So that was really a wonderful job, and this picture helped you a lot to tell you that yes, it is material. So this picture, many of you were telling what are the objects present on the screen and what do we call them, like wooden furniture, you said it is wood, clay, fabric, metal, all these things. So it really helped you to guess the topic. Then I gave you a game where you had to unscramble the words given on the screen. So that helped you a lot to, you know, even though you took turns, you took a little bit time to unpack the central idea, you did a great job. So the central idea was materials behave and interact in certain ways which determine how people use them. So that was right, and I really appreciate you for that. So materials are the, you know, things which helps us in making different objects, right? So this materials have got their own behaviors. Like we humans have our own characteristics, the same way materials do have it. So we are going to explore all that. And this time it's going to be more interesting because we will be doing many experiments to learn about the properties of the materials, to know how they behave, why they behave in such a way, right? So that is the central idea. So it tells us that materials has got its own behavior. They interact, like we speak to each other, materials do interact with each other in a certain way, where it depends upon the situation. For example, it depends upon the temperature, it depends upon the way we use them. So that is what the central idea is all about. So this is going to be a great unit, children. It's going to be fully hands-on activities for you with experiments, a lot to learn. And the learner profile, like you guessed, it is thinker and risk taker, and ATL skills, research and thinking. Because you are going to research a lot and lot in this, we are not going to learn what is already there. That is just a base. We are going to find out a lot and a lot more about materials around us. And you will be risk taker because we have to do lots of experiments, right? And I'm telling you now itself, when you are performing experiments because you are at home, I would suggest you to, you know, take the help of your parents at sometimes. There are not, they are not too much hard that, you know, you need not have assistance, but still it's good that you have the assistance of your parents or your siblings with you. So that is what the central idea is. And again, I asked you to guess the lines of inquiry by giving the game where you had to, you know, interchange the words, and you did a great job in that. Immediately you did that, like even though you took time in unscrambling the central idea, unpacking this central idea, you didn't take any time at all for doing this because it was easy for you. So the lines of inquiry are behavior of the materials. So we are going to learn the properties of the material. What are the properties, whether it is elastic, whether it is stretchy, all those things. And the changing properties, why do materials change its properties, like from one form to another it changes. For example, from solid to liquid, liquid to gas, all those already you know a little bit about that because you had performed at least one or two experiments during the science exhibition conducted last year. But this year it's going to be more and more about it. Okay, the next one is manipulation of the materials for new products. So how can a material change to a different product? So this third line of inquiry is where you will be a risk taker and you will apply a lot and lot of research skill. And one more thing is this third line of inquiry will help us to connect our learning with the SDGs goals, because there are new products, we will be learning what are the effects, what are the impacts of certain materials on the environment. So all this will be learned. So I'm not revealing everything now, but I can assure you this unit is going to be very much interesting. And the concept, key concept, which is going to lead our inquiry is nothing but the for the behavior of the material, it is function because it says how it behaves. And changing properties, definitely it is changed, how it changes from one property to the other. And manipulation is what causes it to change, right? So all this is going to be interesting. And this was your pre-unit assessment where I asked you to, you know, do it in a different way. Like I gave you the definition of the material and it says that a material is a substance, okay, or a mixture of substances. You can mix different materials together and you can make an object out of it. So it can be a pure material or impure material. All the materials won't be pure. You have to process it, right? So all this we'll be learning. And materials can be living on or non-living matter. So there are certain materials that we get from, you know, living things. There are certain materials that we get from non-living things. So this was the definition given to you. So this is the graphic organizer for SEEI, where S stands for state, where the definition will be given to you. And your work is to understand what it is, okay? And you have to write it in your own words, because when you write it in your own words, it will be easy for you to understand and to explain it to others. So you gave a lot of examples and a lot of definition that was excellent. And exemplify stands for giving examples. You have to give one example of a material and one example of a non-material. And here is where you had lots of questions. Is there something that is not made up of a material? So definitely we'll be inquiring about that also. Then illustrate part, you had to draw some material and you had to name it. So this was a great, you know, success, because you had come up with lots and lots of questions, which helped me to collect the student questions in the Padlet. And then I asked you to do a brainstorming so that already you know there are a few materials. So I asked you to, do the brainstorming to collect all the names of the materials because your knowledge is scattered here and there. So we have to bring it in one place. So we did this by, using the Canva and Adobe Spark, and you did a great job in that as well because you did it in a colorful way, different words, different, vocabularies of materials. And this helped you a lot in gathering the details about the materials. And here is where we discussed each about each and every materials, using the five senses math, like how what do you feel when you touch it, what does it smell like, what sound it produces, what does it taste like, how does it look. So we discussed about few materials in the class based on the five senses math. And when I asked you the question, are the description of each material similar, you said no, the description are different. This is where you will be leading your inquiry to the properties of the material. This is where we will understand that properties of material differs from material to material. Even though we say fabric itself is divided into lot, right? So here also you did a great job during the discussion. So this is how we'll be leading our inquiry, children. So be ready for the hands-on activities and the experiments. And I hope you will also enjoy with me because I'm enjoying a lot when I'm talking about the materials to you. Because each one of you are coming up with different perspectives and lot of deep, thinking and lot of deep ideas. That's really wonderful. It shows that how much you are thinking about it. So keep up the good work, children. Keep inquiring like this. And we'll be discussing a lot about this. So until I see you for the next class, bye, take care.